we see it. Some say, take care of them. Some say, we ain't take care of nobody. You know, it's the word hatred a lot of times. Mm-hmm. Even our country, it's amazing how most of us are mixed up with so many different races. You took your DNA, we're so mixed up.
Amen.
But here we got all of a sudden, we don't want this person coming in, we don't want that person. And the whole country is made up of what?
Of a whole nation.
That's right. That's what made America really different from all other countries is that it's a mix of what?
Wow, different races.
Yeah. So, but there's a lot of hate, supremacy groups, and you know, it's not anything really new. It's been around, and it goes all the way back in the scriptures, as we say here, where you find out the two brothers, Cain and Abel. Okay, first murder.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, over what? Over
sacrifice
to God. And one didn't, the Cain didn't feel his was what? Acceptable, so he got mad at
His brother.
Envy at his brother, okay? So we see hate didn't just start today. It's been around. But as believers, how do we combat that? That's the question. Because we're surrounded by it all the time. You know, you get provoked by it, you know. People just say stuff to you and just... It's just provoke. It's just hatred. You know, say good morning. I don't turn up. You know, it's still a good morning. You didn't take my morning away from me.
Amen.
You know, no matter how you react to it, it's still a good day. That's that's the way we believe as believers, not other people.
I speak to people
they
get annoyed. What's good about it?
Yeah. So what's so good about it? What you got to smile on your face?
Mm-hmm.
What's wrong with you?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, we have a reason to, because why? Because we know that what? God's
God
taking care of
us.
It's His grace and mercy that we're still what?
Still here.
But the enemy wants to what? He wants to spread hatefulness even in the speech, attitude. We see it all the time. But it leads to, it says, if it's unchecked, it gradually leads to a destructive and remorseful way of life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when you live a life full of hatred, it's boxing you in. It torments us. It's not the one that you, it's so much that you're hating or whatever. It's tearing you up first. Okay? And then what does it do? It doesn't bring the other person, compel them to come to Christ, because you're not doing that, because why? We're operating in what?
In flesh,
in an evil spirit, which is this jealousy and this envy,
it'll destroy you.
Yes, sir.
I don't know where it's found at, even if it's in the Bible, but the hate destroys the hater. It eventually destroys the person that hates, it eventually destroys them. They'll do something. You know, somebody.
There's a lot of times you upset.
You're upset with them.
Going about their day. Turning flips and stomach upset and taking acids and you don't even know what.
That's it.
Even know what's going on.
That's right.
That's why the scripture tells us you got to argue against your brother.
Go to your brother.
You need to go to him. You need to go and express what your difference. But you can have differences and not be hateful.
Amen.
Okay. You can have differences and not. Be hateful, okay? All right,
God said, Jacob have our love and Esau our hate. But look what happened to Jacob. He got what he did, he got what he did to Esau. It came back on him when he went and asked for Rachel, you know, he got real.
Well, you know, the scriptures, you know, Jesus talks a lot about that. You remember about the man that the scripture said that owed a man some money. His Lord forgave him for his, and then as soon as he got free, he saw the one on him, he got it by the throat. So again, you know, that's hatred being forgiven and yet hated. And that's what, as people, you know, as human beings, God has been so forgiving of us. And that's what he asked. Why are we hating? hateful toward each other when I've been so forgiving or forgiving
of you.
To you.
Amen. Okay?
So that's what we have to think about as believers. That's what Jesus, as he wrote, he was telling the disciples, you know, he gave them this example about how, you know, how mercy works and how you've been forgiven and that you ought to forgive. Oh, there you go.
Amen.
That's right. Because if you don't, first vow is going to destroy you.
Mm-hmm.
Then next vow is going to destroy others.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And then God is not glorified in any of
it.
That's our purpose is to please Him.
Please God.
That's my main purpose is to please. But I can't please Him if I'm being hateful.
Mm-hmm.
I
Amen.
Can't do it. And have you ever caught yourself? You know, you feel it rise up in you. And then the Holy Spirit catch you, and then you bounce back out
mm-hmm,
of
mm-hmm.
Because you know that's not the Spirit of God.
Amen.
You hate that you feel that you felt
that fact,
hate,
mm-hmm.
hate that you felt it, but you still felt it.
Amen.
You have to go God.
Forgive me.
That word, check
me,
Lord.
That's why that word is so important for us.
That's it.
Because it'll let you know, you know, it says, you not overcome with evil.
Mm-hmm.
You overcome
with
evil with
good.
Mm-hmm.
Lord.
The word we depend on that.
Amen.
And it's one thing again, and that's why this is one, like I said, you don't want to miss this one because it affects everybody. You either gonna experience it or you're gonna express it.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's both at the same time.
You
experience and express it at the same time. Well, how do you unravel that? How do we as believers, how do we keep the love of Christ when we're being faced with, you know, a person is out of jealousy,
mm-hmm.
you know, or we on the phone trying to get an understanding, somebody's smart mouthless, or, you know, just okay, you know, it's simple things, just like going somewhere and somebody sees you coming, and they let the door close on.
Mm-hmm.
Look, you know, little thing like that to you know, and it don't have to be anything big, you know, you get attacked, there's a bunch of little
mm-hmm.
big things, you know,
mm-hmm.
aggravate you. I'm gonna get it out of you. I'm gonna pull it out of you. One way or another, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, some days it seem to be more testier than anybody else?
Mm-hmm.
Some days it seem to be more testier
than other days.
But what it's about is what we've had to check our spirit. We have to check our fruit because the enemy is trying to destroy that fruit. It's an enemy against the fruit. It doesn't want it to be beautiful. It doesn't want it to flourish. It wants to contaminate it. And but thanks be to God for the Holy Spirit. Because
amen.
Man, that is our only. It reminds us. It teaches us. It brings this back up as we learn it, so that we don't become hateful like the ones that maybe hate us.
Amen.
You know what? And one blessing I really found out is that I learned to realize that if a person does, or say person or the spirit of a person does come up with hate or something like that, I know I'm not the source of it.
Mm.
That person had some issues before it got to
you. Mm-hmm.
A person may have been, maybe some things are not going right in their life. Maybe it's a physical thing. Sometimes, if a person in pain,
mm-hmm.
you know, you just not as sweet. As
Amen.
When there's no pain.
Amen.
You know,
Amen.
It's just the way it is, okay? So, but not only natural pain, but what?
Some mental.
Maybe, mm-hmm. Some family issues that maybe, some other thing that maybe pressing, and you just come up to the right, that person at the right time. They were ticking. It was the bomb was ticking, and then you just touched it, and then it
explodes.
But you're not the cause of it.
Uh-huh.
But the enemy wants you to respond as though what? As though
mm-hmm.
you did it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But the scriptures let us, as we go into the Word of God, we learn that these spirits are what? They're all around us. They're constantly attacking, trying to attack what? The believer.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So let's look at the first question. It says, so what does the Word say about what?
Hey.
What does the word say about it? Hey, look at 1 John 4:20 says, if a man say, I what?
Yeah.
And do what?
Hey, his brother.
He is a what?
Liar. True thing.
For he loveth not his brother whom he what?
Has
seen. harm.
There you go, God. Who has not sin.
This is what the word is saying about this. If a man say, well, I don't care what you say, he say, but if you got hate following behind it, it negates what you say.
Mm-hmm.
You say that man is a what?
He's a liar.
He's a storyteller.
He's a liar.
He's a liar. And what do we say? God hates what?
Liars.
He just hates it. I'm sorry. Man, no matter how we may try to justify one here or there, God still what?
Hates liars.
He hates it. Because why? He is the truth.
Mm-hmm.
He's the liar.
Mm-hmm.
So if he can't be both, then he wouldn't be true.
Okay? Amen.
All right. 1 John 2:9 says, he did what?
That
said he hates what?
Light hated his brother in the darkness until now.
Even till now. So this is what we're talking about. This is what people say. But this is what God said you are.
Mm-hmm.
What you say don't mean that's what
you are.
What you say don't. Sometimes we say, but that ain't what we really want to say.
Mm-hmm.
We say it that way because we don't really want to say it that way.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we try to what? Try to maybe sweeten it up or say, and sometimes we'll catch ourselves. Well, let me say it this way.
Mm-hmm.
Now, don't say it the way you don't say it because that's really the way you really felt.
Mm-hmm.
When you say I'm gonna say it this way, then you either try to sugarcoat, try mm-hmm. to soften it up,
mm-hmm.
okay? But the scriptures don't soften it up for us, does it?
No, it doesn't.
It says if you say that you're in the light, in other words, you proclaim to be what?
Christian.
Be a child of the king, mm-hmm. okay? Child of the kingdom, a kingdom believer, a worshiper, and then in the same sentence you started talking about how you hate somebody.
Mm-hmm.
You got a problem.
Mm-hmm.
The scripture said that what?
You're lying. Yep. Mm-hmm. Even until now.
So it's not so much what you say, but it's what you do. It's what you do. All right. So what hatred does? Let's talk about what hatred does. Look at Proverbs 10:12. Hatred does what?
Stirred up strife.
It stir up strife. But what does love do?
Covered all sin.
I read this, didn't read it a long time ago. Didn't really think a whole lot about it, but you know what it's a hatred stirred up strife. You get one person,
mm-hmm.
you get a group of people, and you get one person just upset. And if that person keep on going, that spirit will start connecting.
Mm-hmm.
And then the others get into it. Then it turned into a brawl.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it turned. But all of them didn't come there doing that. If you could start with
just one.
One. You know, say, you know so much. Okay. You say one. So it don't take but one.
Mm-hmm.
You can have a family meeting. I put this one. This one really hit. You can have a family reunion. Everybody getting along. You get this one come into it, and they got some issues from
way back when.
Way back or something. And everybody's enjoying each other, and then one person come in and stir up. just stir up, okay? And the other ones, they might not be upset about the same thing, but you still upset them.
Mm-hmm.
Because here you come in, what? Stirring
up.
Mm-hmm. You bringing in things into, so as believers, that's not the mark of what we don't bring in stuff to stir up strife.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? That's not our desire. It says, but hatred stirs up strife. Now,
mm-hmm.
you can stir some things in love too now. You can love somebody and tell them the truth, and it can do what?
Stir
them
up.
It can stir some things too, okay? But love is for what? Love is always going to work for the good.
For the good.
Because you care for the good. But hatred is not working for the good. Right. Hatred says, I just want to be right. I'm going to have my way. I'm not thinking about it. It's selfish.
Mm-hmm.
It's not, but again, there's two types of hate. You just talked about that, right? You talked mm-hmm. about the hatred of hating something the way God hates, and then hating the way
we hate.
Mm-hmm. Even little kids,
mm-hmm.
you know, you get them the same toy, and one will say, that's my toy right there because we got the same toy,
mm-hmm.
and have a fight over it.
Mm-hmm.
Same toy, same thing. So hatred doesn't, it's born into you.
Mm-hmm.
The child too young to know that. or you buy them something to eat.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, let me have one of those french fries that turn.
Mm-hmm.
And look up at you like, yeah. And then you say, I bought it for you. And I said, that must be how God feels about us.
Mm.
He give us everything, and then we
turn our back.
One out of my chip bag. And you better be thankful for that.
Mm.
That's what I always think about. Okay. All right. So hatred stirs up
strife.
It causes tension. But look what love can do. You can always tell the person, you know, that's driven by love. They always try to come in and make it right.
Make it right. Amen.
They try to come. Oh, that ain't no big deal. Oh, we ain't gonna get upset over that. But then you got the other one there, the fan the fire.
Mm-hmm.
Pump it up.
Mm-hmm.
And the other one said, no, we don't have to act that way. We see it in our family, okay?
Amen.
All right. All right. 1 John 2:11. What does this say?
But he that hated his brother is in darkness,
and
walk in darkness,
and know not,
whither he goeth,
because
that darkness hate blind his eye.
This is what hatred does. You think you see it, but it's really doing what? It's
blinded you.
Mm-hmm. Now, most people hate stuff because they don't really look into what, a hatred for a certain group of people, way a certain person dresses or something. If you don't know that person, you jump in early.
Mm-hmm.
Because sometimes the person that may not appear pleasing to you might be the person that will help you.
Amen. That's true.
The person that you think is perfect. Yeah.
That's true. That's true.
Anybody ever experience?
Amen. Mm-hmm.
The person you thought would help you didn't.
Mm-hmm.
And the person you wouldn't let help you.
Drowning
man don't care what.
Hey.
He just
want to
get wet.
Get it. Mm-hmm.
Okay, but soon we get out the water, what happens?
It always makes you come back. Amen.
I want
someone
so that can put their hand on me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. His brother he that hated his brother is in darkness. Who is this talking about? Mm-hmm. Who's the scripture talking about?
What are you
talking about?
Anybody. Yeah.
There you go. There you go. We're talking about us. It says, but he, not just anonymously, but it's talking about anybody that what? That's right. It says, but he. So you, if it's us, we put our name in the blank. We the he. But whatever your name is,
mm-hmm.
It says that hate his brother is in what?
It's in darkness.
And you walking in it.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't know where you're going.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, if you don't know where you're going, then you what?
You're lost.
You're
blind.
That's what he's saying. The world lost when hatred takes over our lives and it takes over our thought being. It torments us. And when you get angry, you do. You get angry or upset. Let me put it directed more toward hatred. With someone or something, okay, you'll start messing up other stuff. You get upset, then you drop the dish.
Mm-hmm.
Then you get the broom, and the broomstick hit you in the face.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It's like when you
a domino factor.
Your mind gets real, just out of
whack.
Yeah, stuff that don't normally happen. Then you get mad. Then you want to use some other. Where is the and that is just a common part. Wow. The hatred went to the next level. It's the got you. Your mind, you don't know what you're doing. And then you'll say, let me sit myself down a minute.
Mm-hmm.
Calm myself. Then you get it back together. Now the Lord, oh Lord, help me. Straight help me, Lord. Okay, now we get back to what?
Mm-hmm.
We coming back.
Mm-hmm.
can I read that?
Yeah, go ahead, sure.
In the book of Ephesians, it just come up on me for what you're talking now and bring up a whole lot of scripture. It says, be not hasted in thy spirit to be angry, for anger resteth in the bosom of fools. I just, just popped up.
A lot of times that anger is, like you said, it can come out of either the jealous mode where I act this way because I'm scared I'm going to lose something. Or it comes out of, I'm just selfish. I don't want to see nobody else do better.
Mm-hmm.
Whew, that's, That's it's like those are the two driving modes. Not always, it's more, but there are two major modes that we have to deal with as human, because we have emotions, we have feelings, it's there, but it has to be what? It has to be harnessed.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't harness it, then it goes to bigger things. Let me get my shot out here.
Mm-hmm.
Say see, but it start out with what? I just don't like
it. Uh-huh.
Or start boiling.
Mm-hmm.
The next thing it turn into a rage, hatred. You know, then they say, mm-hmm. wait a minute, let me get my, oh man, that's mm-hmm. what we see on the news, somebody
mm-hmm. it's out of control.
The hatred is turned, the thing that you hated, the thing that you love turned to hate now.
Mm-hmm.
It's just as strong, it's a strong force, okay, but it has to be what? It has to be contained. Anger is an emotion, but it has to be what?
It has to be contained.
Okay, it has to have what? It has to have restraint. Mm-hmm. Okay, but the word here is telling us what hatred does, how it makes you act, the condition that you're in. You think you see everything. You just hate so bad, and just got you blind, and the other person don't even feel it like you feel it.
Mm-hmm.
That's you doing it.
Mm-hmm.
They don't feel that like you do. You may want to.
Mm-hmm. Hey,
I
man.
Just want to scare him real bad. I don't really want to do nothing. I just want to scare him real
mm-hmm.
bad. And then you might, where's the line?
Mm-hmm.
Well, if you scare him, they have a heart attack.
Uh-huh.
You know, can't undo that, can we?
Amen.
Or have an accident. Something else happens. You got their mind off and upset them, and they drove off and left your house and ran through a light and an 18-wheeler hit them.
Mm-hmm.
That's real life things. It happens.
Mm-hmm.
People upset or just hate somebody or envious, and then end up what? You end up destroying them
mm-hmm.
or the life of what? Someone else. Mm-hmm. So it doesn't have to be intoxication all the time. It's more people intoxicated with hate
mm-hmm.
than they'll be with alcohol.
Amen.
This is intoxicating right here.
Mm-hmm.
Hatred is poison. It just destroys it. But there's a good kind of hate. Well, we hate the things that God hates, or we hate the issue of lying on somebody, or those two type of things that hate evil, but not good.
Mm-hmm.
God loves us. He loves righteousness because He's a righteous God. And He wants us to what? Walk in what? Righteousness,
righteous.
Not in darkness, but walk in the what?
Light.
Okay, because He is what? He's the
light.
Proverbs 26:24-26, and what does this say?
He that hated dissembles
with
lips,
lips
and layeth up deceit within him.
So hatred makes you start breaking things down. Break, dissemble, up to us, simple means to put together.
Mm-hmm.
Dissemble means tear apart. Okay. So we can destroy, hatred can destroy. Something that's even good, hatred comes into what? Come in and destroy.
Mm-hmm.
It comes in to destroy. All right? And what? It lay up deceit within in you. It
mm-hmm.
starts building up. It's like it's like the first step, you know, it turns into, it's I'm angry. Then it turns into, I'm not just angry, I'm mad.
Mm-hmm.
The next thing is, I'm gonna have to act and do something about it. You know, then it goes up a little, I'm gonna get some help, get somebody else upset with me.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't have to do it all. So it's like the stages.
Mm-hmm.
The enemy just take that, but all the time, on the inside, I love God. He's the head of my life. I can't do nothing without Him. But I'm mad now.
Mm.
I'm hateful now. Well, the way we got contracts here. Okay. Would it happen sometime? Yes,
mm-hmm.
as believers, yeah, you're gonna be challenged. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is, be alert to what it is doing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it's just like I'm sure Aunt Barbara, like in medical, different things. And, you know, they try to make you aware of what happens. What, you know, you gonna have kidney problems, but they got programs to make you aware of the things
mm-hmm.
that what. Yeah, well, that's what this. This is an awareness program.
Mm-hmm.
Right now.
All right.
If we can make you aware of it. Then it's a good chance. What we can prevent it.
Mm-hmm.
But if you ain't aware of it.
You don't know.
You
chances are you have a better chance.
Okay, so this is awareness, not
Amen.
Hatred, okay? All right, Matthew 6 and 15 says,
but if
you
not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses.
Okay, so, you know, this is what hatred does. Hatred, I ain't forgive nobody. This is just too bad. But then what about in your life? What about in our life? You know, what have we done that was too bad?
Mm-hmm.
I don't see those things. But guess what? God
sees
it. Amen. He search our what?
Our heart.
He search our intentions, our thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
So, that's all.
You know, I was just thinking about this young man, Dylan Luke, the one that killed the church members in Charlotte.
North Carolina? Okay. Yeah.
Well, you know, they sentenced him to death. But when you think about it, we'd like for him to live to see the error of his ways and ask for forgiveness. Because right now he's not repentant. But, you know, that's what, you get to a point where you want people to ask God for forgiveness.
Mm-hmm.
And as, that's true, because as we grow, and as, you know, even a person again that, no matter how horrific the deed may give, may have taken place, that's a softness in a believer, because you don't want that person destroyed, even though, I mean, so that's justice. But then again, is it? You know, it's kind of one of those
thin lines
of the heart. Right. Man, you really want that person to, like you say, to repent and turn and come to God and be forgiven, but, you know, but.
And if he still dies, at least he dies with a repentant heart. He knows where he's going then.
And usually, you know, usually that takes place where they'll try to get a chaplain or somebody. They usually try to get somebody to try to break through that, you know. And usually people say, well, you know, your last request, or, you know, and they'll ask you, are you at peace with God? And if that person, they're not going to accept it, then it's nothing. But the effort you is made before a person goes to facing a death or sentence or something like that, it's trying. But again, you know, some things we see doesn't mean that it's the end of the story. You know, we don't know what that person may have done in private.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's just like a person being saved. I mean, just because they didn't come down on the for an hour to do it before, everybody don't mean they're not
saved.
You don't know what really goes on that person's mind
on the inside
when they're not in front of them.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, that's why God is the judge. I'm so glad.
Amen. Because
we can't see everything. You know, we can't do it. Yeah. All right. Good points. Good points. All right. So what does Christ say about hatred? Look at John 15:18. It says,
If the world hates you, you know that it hated me before it hated you.
Okay, who was he talking to?
He's talking to us.
But he was talking to the
disciples.
Disciples
of Christ.
Followers
of Christ.
Followers of Christ. So he talked to the disciples. They were followers. And the apostles, they were followers. And he's explaining to them about their walk.
This is Christ.
So you think you're having a rainy day because you're a Christian?
Hmm.
He said, wait a minute. He said this. He said, I know they're going to hate you if you follow what I do. He said, they're going to hate you. Why? Because they hated me.
Mm-hmm.
And so if you're in fellowship with what? that tends to be true.
Uh-huh.
You know, if you're in a family and your family, you got, let's say, I'm just using Papa as well. Let's just say him and his brother don't get along. Let's just say him and Uncle C, I'm just using for example. Man, they get into it all the time, they can't stand each other. What you think the offspring gonna do? They're gonna be the same thing. They're gonna be the same thing. They're gonna be just if they see hate between them,
mm-hmm.
what they gonna do?
They gonna show hate.
They don't even know why they do it. It just it follows.
Mm-hmm.
And then they'll say, I don't want you all going over there. I don't want you going over to see her.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want you going over journey out. That's how families get what?
Divided.
Mm-hmm. Hate you.
You know, what I think he was saying is don't let hate control you. Don't worry about the world hating you. You know, the Sermon on the Mount, he said, blessed are you when men persecute you, revile
right.
you, say all manner of evil.
That's right.
You, false in my sake.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to remember that. But otherwise, I think about what the Lord did for us. What he went through, people rejected him. How he talked to them, and he didn't rail on them. He just told them the truth, and they accepted.
Mm-hmm.
So
right.
if they did it to him, what about you?
Mm-hmm.
What about me?
Mm-hmm.
They gonna do it to us too.
Amen.
But then don't let it bother. That's
mm-hmm.
what I think.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Walk around with people just like you.
That's right.
We don't know it anyway.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. That's the tragedy of it.
Mm-hmm.
And here we being tricked, thinking somebody thinks bad of us and worrying about it. That person, I believe they ain't thinking about it. You can't go into search another man's mind. You don't
mm-hmm.
know what's in another man's mind.
That's
you
it.
Can I add a little,
insight?
Somebody said that God has a sense of humor.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I saw a sign on a man's death once, and it read like this. It said, don't tell others your trouble. Said half of them won't care, and the other half will be glad you got what was coming to you.
Oh,
in other words, if you got problems, tell the Lord about it. Yeah. Tell yourself, tell everybody.
Mm-hmm.
He can fix it.
The other said he got it coming to you anyway. Goodness.
Yeah.
Woo. Okay, that's it, man. That's good. Okay, So Christ, he knows, how can he tell us how to deal with it if he had experience? He's saying, wait, before you as a believer
mm-hmm.
talk about you being hated, he says, he didn't start with you.
Mm-hmm.
Started with me.
He
said, started with him.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm talking about. When we're faced with the enemy attacks, he's trying to attack that fruit, and he brings hate, somebody just hateful. It's nothing you did. It's nothing you said. And if you're not careful, you'll absorb all that. And then you're having a bad day about something that you didn't have anything to do with.
Mm-hmm.
It came to destroy you. Mm-hmm. It came to get under your skin. It came to get you. Mm-hmm. And if you don't have the defense of the word, what's going to happen?
It's going to get you.
You're going to give in and get involved.
Mm-hmm.
You don't get involved over something that. But guess what? We're supposed to be what? Different.
Right? Mm-hmm.
The scripture said that if we say we hate him, I don't hate you. I hate the spirit in you.
Mm-hmm.
I hate the evil thing that's in you, but I don't hate
you.
Okay? So we can't, it's not hating the creation, but it's the spirit of what?
That's dwelled in
it. Right there. Mm-hmm. And you got to be able to what? Divide that.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Okay. So Christ is familiar with what?
With
hatred.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody know about hatred is him.
Amen.
He wasn't accepted. They said he was not the son of the living God. They denied him. They falsely accused him. He knows all about hatred. He sentenced to death and didn't do nothing wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what more hate can you get when somebody tries to take what your life?
Amen.
So that's to the extreme. All right. So here's the question. How can I overcome hatred? Matthew 5:44. Let's get some insight. It says, but I say unto you, do what?
Love your enemy.
So I said, I don't want that one. He said, you overcome by what?
Loving your enemy.
And do what?
Bless them that curse you.
Somebody said, that first one is enough.
Mm-hmm.
No, it's not enough. It says, bless them that what?
Curse you.
And then what?
Do good to them that hate you.
Do good to them that hate you.
And pray for them that despitefully use you and persecute you.
And then pray for them?
Mm-hmm.
Which you know are using you.
Mm-hmm.
How you going to pray for somebody you know are using?
Mm-hmm.
That's
hard. Yeah.
You can overcome what? You can even overcome that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? That's how the only way to overcome hatred is by what? It's by love. You gotta activate love. Can you do it on your own?
No.
No. No, you have to have the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit has to what?
Dwell in you.
Guide us and then lead us. So I can't love that. Oh, yes, you can. Because guess what? If you don't get over this time, it's going to show up again. It's going to show up again. Yes, sir. Okay. It says that do good to them.
Yes.
Do good to them. Nah, I'm gonna, as soon as I get them out of my face, that's going to be it. That's not what the word says.
No.
It says do what? Good
do to them that hate you.
That hate you. And then do what?
Pray for them which despitefully use you.
You know what I'm talking about? You can't pray hateful. Hatefulness and prayer don't
work just, together.
Don't hatefulness, I got to go get somebody else to pray because I can't do it because I'm mad. Okay? so you can't do it.
Amen.
You have to come out of that. You got to step out of it. Yeah, you can't stand that mode because guess what? It's cutting out your fellowship with God.
Amen.
When you hate for something, you cut your fellowship out with God. That's the real tragedy for believers. I don't want to cut my fellowship with God out.
Amen.
Because over something that I really didn't have
control over in the first place.
I just thought that, okay, so. He tells us we overcome by blessing, we overcome by loving, we overcome by praying.
Doing good.
Look at Luke 6, 27 through 36, this is one scripture here. It says, but I say unto you, which here? Say which here.
Which here?
Yeah. Everybody hearing that, huh? He said, I say to you, which
here?
Do what?
Love your enemy.
And here it is again, and do what?
Do good to them that hate you.
Anybody ever try that? Somebody will give you a chance. And you decide you're going to be nice to that person that overlook you and just say stuff to you and you just be nice to them. What is the effect? What usually happens?
They change. They think something wrong with
they
you. Why? Why you being nice to me? Yep.
Why you treat me that way?
They get scared.
They get scared. They're really right because it's like
I've had that to happen to me.
I
treated you.
Okay, so that's how that's one way of what do I do with it? What do I do with it? You put the knife to somebody's throat and here they handing you a birthday. You still gonna be nice.
You
have
to pray for them.
Yeah.
Prayer. What is prayer gonna do?
It could change.
That's right. Prayer does what?
Change.
It's supernatural, right? It's great that we can't do it. Guess what? Don't give up hope. Sometimes it's not for you to correct it. Sometimes it's only for God to
do it.
So many times we what? Speak to God about it. Before you go what?
Do something.
Put your hand into the beast's mouth. Ask God, what would you have me say? How would you have me say? Lord, word my mouth. Seasoning my conversation, right?
Amen.
Okay. All right, so I overcome. Another way, David, when he prayed, Psalms 51 and 10 says, do what?
Created me a clean heart, oh God.
Created me a clean heart, what?
Oh God. And renew a right spirit within me.
Casting out away from thy what?
From thy presence. And take thy Holy Spirit from me.
Okay, so we know that David was what? He's a leader. He's a king. Always what? God had given him that ability as a leader. But guess what? David still had what? Conflicts.
He had issues.
These people hated him because God had given him favor. These people hate him because he's a leader. What, Saul hated him because he killed 10,000 versus his 1,000. He upset because they danced in the street over David, and they ain't dancing over me. And here he is protecting the nation, and then Saul set out to kill him.
That's right. Jealousy.
Yeah. It's really both. It's jealousy
and envy.
Yeah. Because he's afraid he's going to lose, and does Saul lose what he? That's he did lose. He was he was a dethroned for being the king. He did lose, and guess who moved in his place?
David.
One he hated. Yeah. And the one he hated loved him.
Mm-hmm.
He could have killed him, but then what?
He
didn't do it. He said, this is the anointing of God. He said, even though he's acting this way, God still what?
The same thing happened when Jesus was born.
Yep.
Herod, what could a little baby do to a grown man who had been king and was going to be king until somebody else, until he died? Yeah.
That's a good example. Yeah. 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 We see examples in the scriptures, you know. Okay. So he says, but Moses says, but I say unto you which hear. That's key.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to be open to what? To hear this message. I say to you, which hear.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta have an ear. You gotta have an ear to hear what this word is saying before it'll take effect, or it's just words. So I say to you, which hear, which receive it. Okay, love your enemy and do good to them which hate you. And guess what? Don't worry. You're gonna get practice. Okay, it's gonna come up enough times. So you get practice, so I never get a chance to do it.
Oh yeah.
A chance. So David is saying, create me what?
A clean heart.
In defense. Defense of what? He says, create me a clean heart. So that indicates that David's heart must not be what?
Cleansed.
It must not be right for him to say, create what? Clean. Mm-hmm. He must have got what?
Something happened.
Dirty.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so he says, create me a what?
Clean heart.
I'm feeling clean right now. Mm-hmm. Okay, oh God. And then do what? He said, then
renew
the
spirit in me.
So that indicates what? If you have to renew a right spirit, that indicates what? It was gone. There you go. Mm-hmm. So did David love God?
Yeah.
God loved David. Mm-hmm. But yet look what occurred, right?
Mm-hmm.
So that means we have to do what? We got to depend on him.
Yeah.
We got to depend on him.
Amen.
He said, renew the right spirit in me, because he's talking, David constantly talking about his enemies, how they hate him, how they despise him, how they set up camps against him. All these things that are going on, trying to destroy him. And then he just says, Lord, I need help. Create me a clean heart. And he says, cast me out away from thy presence. Now remember, we talked about hatefulness separates us from what? Fellowship with God.
Mm-hmm.
That's the most, you know, okay. I can separate from man, but I don't want to be separate from God. Guess what? Because I'm not going to be happy.
Mm-hmm.
I separate from God because why? That's the joy of my life. That's the spirit of my life. That's my source.
Amen.
Okay? So he says, cast me not away from thy presence. Why does he say cast me not away from thy presence? Because he knows if that spirit ain't right.
Right. Yeah. He ain't going to be right.
He's going to be disconnected.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? All right. Then he says, and take not what?
The Holy Spirit from me.
Because that's the only thing. Because if you take that away from me, I'm a bad boy. I'm tough. I'm just not good without it. So don't take what? Your spirit. But if we come disconnected with God, guess what? That's that heaviness you feel.
Mm-hmm.
If you ever felt that, or something going on in your life, and you felt like you were disconnected from God, that happens to believe.
Mm-hmm.
There are times you're going to feel disconnected. Okay, and then you have to go back and check. What am I experiencing right now? Is it some hatred going, some things I need to forgive in my life? Is it something that's causing me to feel
disconnected?
Separated.
Mm-hmm.
And then the Holy Spirit will show me what it is. And will show it is. Okay, now go do something about it. Whatever it is that you need to do. You need to get that what off of your heart. You got to clean it up. You got to ask for, you got to forgive that you may be also what?
Forgiven.
Mm-hmm. I want you to forgive me, but I ain't gonna forgive you. You got to work like that. Mm-hmm. If you don't do it, then you can't receive it. Look, John 3:5 says, Jesus answered, verily, verily, I say unto thee,
except a man be what? Born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God.
Okay, let's start right there. So where is the kingdom of God? What do you think the kingdom of God is?
In heaven.
Where is it?
In heaven.
It's in the body, believe what anybody else. What's the kingdom of God? Is it someplace somewhere?
In heaven.
It's you. That's right. It's the kingdom of God. It's not somebody that's heaven. Mm-hmm. No, the kingdom of God is here right now.
Mm-hmm.
For those that participate, that he says, I give you the keys to the kingdom. So the keys of the kingdom is what? It's salvation. It's believing that Christ, that he what? That
he is
the Son of the living God, and that he what? He gave his life. He was resurrected and coming back again, that we're forgiven for what?
Our sin
in the world. Okay, so it says you must be born of the world. That's how we overcome hatred is we can't do it our own. Mm-hmm. We got to be born of this water
and of the Spirit. Of the
Spirit of God. That's what changes us. Because normally, brother saying, we just bad to the bone. You just come here like that, okay? Mm-hmm. But when we're born again, something happens. Mm-hmm. Something happens. Now the love of Christ is what? We become what? Back into the family of God. And now we can love again because that bad blood, that sin, what separated us, that is hateful, and envy, and jealous, and all those things. But guess what? We can get it back again by being what? We got to be born again.
Amen.
We can get it back. And that comes from what? Through Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. He cannot enter the kingdom of God. So the kingdom of God is not a faraway place. Kingdom of God is right, existing right now. Mm-hmm. You're part of it. Kingdom of God. That's what this fruit is. It's those characteristics that come with the kingdom. Kingdom believers. Mm-hmm. That you no longer desire to be hateful and envious. And you combat those things, but it's not your what? Desire.
Right.
Whereas before it's my desire, I'm going to be the baddest on this street. I'm going to run this my block. Man's like, okay, Lord, this your block. Yeah. Like, Lord, take up the same thing you thought you were in control of. Now you're asking what?
God to do it.
That's getting into the kingdom of God. That means he's what? You're in his rulership. Mm-hmm. Okay? So kingdom of God is not a place. Kingdom is here. For those that what? That worship and believe in him. Okay. And that which is born of the flesh is what?
Flesh.
And that which is born of the spirit
is spirit.
Is spirit. Okay, so again, that's the condition. The born of the flesh, you're gonna react to the flesh. You pinch me, I'm gonna pinch you back. Mm-hmm. That's flesh to flesh. Okay? Mm-hmm. You say something to me bad, I'm gonna give it back to you just as bad. Mm-hmm. You know, you take something from me, I'm gonna take twice as much from you. That's flesh to flesh. Mm-hmm. Okay? That's flesh to flesh. But born of the spirit says, you can take from me, that's all right. God can give me some more.
Mm-hmm.
See, that's, now we're moving to another zone because we're not depending on what?
On flesh.
So it says, marvel not
that I say unto thee, you must.
What's marveling?
Like, just in all, be amazed.
That's right.
In all, yeah.
Amazed. Mm-hmm. He says, marvel not that I say unto you,
you must be born again.
This is talking about Nicodemus, about his experience. Okay? Mm-hmm. Well, he's trying to figure out how can a man, you know, just go back to his mother's womb and say, no, of course, that's flesh to flesh.
Mm-hmm.
But he's talking about the spiritual man and how we change.
Mm-hmm.
What we desire is different. You know, as the deeper we go into this word, your desires are different because now what? You try to please God. So you got to know that what the enemy's doing in order to be successful. Every team, they study. When they go oppose another team, that coach takes them in that room and they spend time in the film. Mm-hmm. That's what they do. So we got to figure out how to counter against them in order to win.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same thing. You got spiritual strategies.
Mm-hmm.
You got the strategy. Yeah. So give me an example of spiritual strategy. Let's give an example of what maybe something we talked about hate and says the only way to overcome hate, the strategy for overcome hatred of the person that hate you is to do what love. That's the strategy.
Mm-hmm.
Since we're, like to keep to ourselves, just speak to people you don't normally speak to.
Okay. That's a strategy, right?
Mm-hmm. Just people you connect. Don't know. People open doors for people and smile at them and say hello.
Yeah. That's a difference. That's a difference because that means what? I'm extending myself.
Mm-hmm.
I'm extending myself. Guess what? Because there's plenty of me. There's plenty to go around. There's plenty. I got plenty of joy to share.
Mm-hmm. Man.
With anybody, now I can't make you take it, but you ain't gonna take mine.
Mm-hmm.
So open the door, you just walk through and say, don't say thank you. It's not gonna make me hateful.
Yeah.
It can't help us.
That's one of the requirements for Christianity.
Yeah.
Is what Jesus says, if you salute them that salute you, what thank have you?
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
He says, salute everybody.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you'd be surprised how people will stop to talk to you just by you speaking.
I know, you know, my word is, whenever somebody asks me, I always say, I'm blessed. And I notice when I say I'm blessed and then get ready to leave and say, you have a blessed day, some people just look like they're surprised to hear somebody say that. And it's just like, you can see the smile or something on their face.
But
you don't.
Sometimes they respond and say, I'm blessed too.
Yep.
Say that nobody
would. Yep.
But you.
Yep.
But yeah,
I get that.
Mm-hmm. that they are
blessed.
Just go to somebody and say, what's going on? I said, oh, God's good.
Mm.
He sure is.
Yeah,
like, I was like, God, man, it turned out. I was like, you know, but he is good. Mm-hmm. But if I had to say, oh, I said, oh, ain't nothing.
Mm-hmm.
Just left it like that. But, you know, I might say nothing. I said, but you know what?
God is good.
That's
uh-huh.
what happened today. I said, it's a good day. Man, just like somebody just took
Mm-hmm.
Electrocuting them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like,
you're
right.
It is a good
day. You know, but it's our work. It's how we are. Mm-hmm. But if we hateful,
that's it.
Might not say
nothing at all. Mm-hmm.
More than that, you won't say nothing.
Mm-hmm. May not look at you. You know, just, you know. So, again, we have opportunities, again, to do good to them mm-hmm. that work. You're not going to run out of there, I promise. Mm-hmm. If you run out, come see me. Please, I want to see the person that can do more good than that runs out of people to do good to people that don't do
good to them. Mm-hmm.
And we'll get discouraged sometimes as believers, as parents, mm-hmm. and whatever. We'll get discouraged because I feel like the return is not there.
Mm-hmm.
But you still have to what? Jesus say it's not about it. He didn't say, when you do good to them, they're going to finally do good to you. He didn't say that.
No, he didn't.
He didn't say, if you do it enough, they will. He didn't say that either, did he?
He didn't.
Did you know you got spiritual growth? It doesn't matter.
That's it.
Say hello to you, or if they walk past you when you're holding the door open.
Mm-hmm.
That's your choice.
You can feel good about yourself.
That's it. That's it.
It's about pleasing God. It's really not what you want.
Yeah.
But mm-hmm. I open the door because, man, I feel like God wants me to be cautious.
Mm-hmm.
I do it because I'm not really doing it just because it's you.
Mm-hmm.
But if you want to take it that way, that's not my motive.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for anything, you know, it has to be the motive what? It has to be, the motive has to please God. That's not the motive. But the scriptures, as we looked at the fruit of the Spirit, and then we got one more lesson this, and we should better cover the last of it. But this hatred and envy, it's something that you're gonna be faced with. We'll face it with challenge, you know. And my grandson, I tell him, he in school, I hate math. I hate social. And I said, don't say hate. Don't say you hate. So you don't like it, don't say you hate it. I said, because you need to learn. Fool hate instruction.
Mm-hmm.
Fool hate, he don't wanna learn. He don't tell you nothing because he already know it all.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes you stop and listen.
Mm-hmm. And learn.
You know, inquire on God about it before what? Before you start lashing out.
Mm-hmm.
So, but we have to do what? We gotta practice.
Amen.
That's what this is. These are kingdom practices. You know, and unless you want this, you can't do it. But you got to be aware that it exists.
Mm.
If you're not aware of it, you can't fix it. Mm. You have to be aware. Mm. And that's what this word is telling us in Galatians. It's telling us those things that are the works of the flesh. And when they're manifest, what occurs? It will destroy you. You get all the pleasure you want. It will destroy you. It will take you out. Okay? It seems pleasurable, but it's going to take you out. I always like to get the last word. I'm going to say what I got to say last.
Mm-hmm.
Then as you grow as Christ-like, this ain't the time to say it.
Mm-hmm.
But go back a few years, I'm gonna get the last word in. Yeah. But then now, well, Lord, if you don't want me to say it, it's not time for me to say anything. Is it a battle?
Yes.
Yeah, it's a battle sometimes. Mm-hmm. That tongue ready to go.
Mm-hmm.
But the Spirit says, it's profitable, you right, but it's not right to say it like that.
Right now.
That's when you, when the flesh is made what? That's when you're yielding yourself to God and not letting the flesh just what hand in hand. It can. It will. But out the Spirit of God, without asking God to what? To control us, to guide us, then we loose. I mean, we have to have any other thoughts or questions or anything we're discussing now?
I was just thinking about that last comment about being born again. I was thinking about when we're first born, we come out of flesh.
Mm.
But when we're born again, the Spirit comes into us.
Mm-hmm.
So nothing goes out. Well, it goes out, but the Spirit has to come in first.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good thought, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you have to... We're adopted. That's what it said. We're going to have a train, like a transfusion.
Mm-hmm.
The new, his blood versus our blood.
Mm-hmm.
You know? So it's like, and that's what's happening. He's constantly what? Purging
us. Mm-hmm.
Our impurities out of us to perfect us to be what he wants us to be.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to stay totally dependent on him.
Mm-hmm.
You got to stay dependent on him, because if you let go, and that's what happens, if you let go, and you let that overtake you, and I'm gonna tell you, the enemy likes to get the insects that's closest to you to affect you.
Mm-hmm.
He's gonna get the things that dear to you
mm-hmm.
to try to crank this up in you. Because the stuff not dear to you ain't gonna really bother.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
It's the things that's close, the people that are close to you. People that you really love.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can't understand it, why it's like, the more I live, like the more you know, that happens a lot of times. But listen, but the scripture said, I'm not going to do it according to what you do. I'm going to do it according to what God tells me to do.
Mm-hmm.
That takes the weight off of it, because now I'm not simply expecting, waiting, and it don't come. And I'm upset, and I'm looking all upside that person's head, and I don't want to be around you, and I have to speak to you. That's too much work.
Amen.
What y'all think?
Too much.
Too much.
You're supposed to love without expectation. But that's hard to do.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. So that residual blood,
mm-hmm.
you know, because that's the work of the flesh.
Mm-hmm.
I did this before. You don't do that
better. It can be done.
Yeah, it can be done.
It can be done.
It can be done.
Mm-hmm.
But we have to do what?
I think that's where the more people mistreat you and ignore you and ostracize you and don't say good things about you, the more you pray for them. The Bible said, when a man's way to please the Lord, he makes even
in his footsteps.
That's one way to have peace, is just to pray for people when they mistreat you. Lord, I'm going to do this.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Yeah, that's the attitude we got to have. I'm going to.
It's through Christ that strengthens me.
Let's take the offense instead of the defense.
That's it.
The ball in our hand. But the enemy said, you don't have no ball.
Look,
they running everything. And then, no, it's not. You take the offense. If God is on your side, then you should be the one with the ball. Instead of saying, I'm going to get that ball. You got
that ball.
When you're blind, you think, well,
they've got it.
Got the advantage. It's you.
Mm.
And that's the trick. And that's why our faith has to be fed. You got to feed your faith. You know, we need that. Feeding it.
Brother, another thing is, we can't forget about that flesh that we dwell in here. Because a lot of times, it'll mislead us too.
So, yeah, we have to acknowledge our what?
Our ways.
That's right. That's why you got to constantly acknowledge to him. Lord, you in charge. Lord, you Lord of my life. No, that's why you have to say a lot of times, you know, we want him as a savior, but we don't want him as Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, he's Lord and savior. He's Lord, then you do what he tells you.
Mm-hmm.
But we want the savior part. Just get me out of my trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Now, he's Lord
and yes. Savior.
So this part right here is the part where you gotta, you really gotta say, Lord, you're gonna come on in here because I need some correction in these areas. And you know what? That's why it's written, because he already know.
Amen.
Okay, so no need to, don't anybody get upset. Like my neighbor said, don't puff up, go up. Don't get upset. He said, go up with it. You know, let the word, you know, grow you to what.
Amen.
Don't deny it. Because that's why scripture said, I like to report where it says, if a man say he loved God and then hate his brother, that got me right there, bro. Saying, I was like, bam. I was like, oh, man. I got to take that in, right? You know, I feel that. I am a monster, some 12 by, and that word is going, bam, right there. Oh, man. But I say I love God. I can't tell Sister K I love God. I'm hating on
him.
Because that word, now I know better because it just told me. Mm-hmm. And she said, oh, he loved God. I hate this kicking over here. You know? And God is looking at the what? The both of us, right? He's watching me lie to her. And then I'm lying to him now, and I'm lying to her. And then I'm lying to myself.
Hey.
Well, we got a lie party going. Anyone else? Right. Y'all enjoying this?
Amen.
It's helping me as I go. When you teach the word, it's helping you. Because when you speak it, in these scriptures, you know, y'all can go back on. Like I said, we couldn't go through all the Proverbs, but I really, that Proverbs 16 through 19, where those things, where it said those things that, man, I've been doing a study on that, on of all the sin. It says it's the catalog of sin, summed up the thing that God despises or he hates for our lives because he knows that it's going to work. It's going to destroy us. We don't take heed, it will destroy us. So we never let hatred take over in no form. Because hatred is a power, but love is the greatest power.
Power.
So hatred is a power. But love, what? It's just greater
than
our powers.
Amen. All
right. We want to thank God for those listening on the phone. Thank God for you. We pray that you